Oh. before your thirst for revenge beckons our own. I can no longer trust your words.
In the end, I knew this day would come. The nature of your kind, I am certain, will always show itself.
Apologies. Oh, mother. Wife. And child.
Kindly Mikula never betrays a vow. Go. Your family awaits you. Ah, there you are. Well fought. You have my gratitude. He was never going to see eye to eye with us. But his words were ill-founded. It was hard to hear, I know. I know I shouldn't let myself, but I suppose it's only natural to feel the weight of one's deeds at times like these. There's plenty left to be done, and I will see to it. Who else, I wonder? I don't enjoy casting suspicion on anyone I've called a comrade. But it's a small sacrifice in the grand scheme of things. We must eradicate all doubt. Who else, I wonder? I don't enjoy casting suspicion on it, but it's a small... Oh, there you are. Good. If you happen to see Lady Leda, tell her that I'm striking out on my own. Don't worry. I've no mind to cross any of you. The guidance of kind Mikula remains etched into my very flesh. It's only... there's something that I must know. Kindly Mikula spoke of the vow he once made with General Radahn, and it is here the vow shall be honored. I am a Redmayne. I must know the nature of the vow. I'll be out on my own for some time. There's something I must know. There is no need for concern. I will be true to my word. Though I do feel a hint of regret, Lady Leda, Honorable Ansbach, and warriors like you are all of a special breed. How glorious it would have been had we met in battle as sworn enemies. I'll be out on my own, for there's something I must...
Kindly Mikula has discarded his great rune. The fog that vexed my aging faculties has been lifted, and follies better left forgotten haunt me once again. Once, in an attempt to free Lord Moak from his enchantment, I challenged Tender Mikula, only to have my own heart rather artfully stolen. I knew not how weak I was. I believed that with sufficient mastery, even an Empyrean would be within reach of my blade. I could not have been more mistaken. Mikula the Kind is a monster, pure and radiant. He wields love to shrive clean the hearts of men. There is nothing more terrifying. Righteous tarnished, Mikula the Kind makes my blood run cold. I am loath to admit it, but even at this very instant, I wish to run very far away indeed. Righteous tarnished, I am...
Thank you.
Just tarnished. It's been some time. After unburdening my soul to you, I had hoped to make a fresh start, but there was one thought I could not dislodge from my mind. So, here I am, quite unable to move on. After Lord Moke's slaying at his dynastic palace, it appears his body has been absconded with and taken straight to Kind Mikala. Surely you recall that I once served Lord Moog as a pureblood knight, after failing him in every regard, and losing sight of my vows. I'd do anything to make amends, in whatever meager way I can. What could they possibly have in mind for Lord Moog's remains? The implications are rather unnerving. What could they possibly have in mind for Lord Moog's remains?
Fidgety little letters. Never make sense of this jumble. Oh, hello. I'm afraid I'm busy. Ugh, a curse upon my lack of foresight. I should have asked Ansbach to impart his knowledge when I had the chance. I'm afraid I'm busy.
Possibly have in mind for Lord Moak's remains. The implications are rather unnerving. Well, what's this? Yes. Yes, I should have known. Even the truth was itself mere folly. As if using Lord Moog to gain entrance to the Land of Shadow were not enough, he plans to use his corpse as the vessel of his king consort. He has forsaken Lord Moog's soul. He desires only his empty shell. It beggars belief, but I'm afraid Tentamikala fails to grasp the humiliation implied by this act. One thing is certain. My dear Lord deserved better. Righteous Tarnished, you have my gratitude. You have given me the answers I needed, but I can hardly fathom it. Such folly. Unto the end. I am a warrior, but I've aged. I cannot afford to act hastily. Curse it all. I know my limits. I could spend the rest of my life honing my craft, and still that creature would be out of my blade's reach. The absolute folly of it all. Freya, by the gods. She must be feeling the need to reaffirm her allegiance before she heads to war. A true Red Mane she is, hardly troubled by the rot. Righteous Tarnished, could you please give this to Freya? Thanks to you, she too will have the answer she requires. Yes. I can see her barreling into the fray right now. Perhaps I shouldn't meddle in her affairs, but this is the only way I can help. Perhaps this is the only...
I'm afraid I'm busy. Truly. I should have asked Ansbach to impart his knowledge when I had the chance. From Sir Ansbach? To me? What on earth could it... Yes. Of course. I see. As the Festival of War concluded, General Radahn's soul met an honorable end, but kindly Mikala wishes to revive it. Which is fine by me. I know it would pain old Jeren, but war has always suited General Radahn best, and certainly far more than any honorable death. Endless war to invigorate the soul, as befits General Radahn, the Great Lion. Thank you. Now I finally cast off my misgivings. Give my regards to Honorable Ansbach. Tell him, if we should meet in battle, to face your bow would be fine enough, but to face your blade would be an honor. Brave warrior, perhaps next time we too will meet on the battlefield.
I'm afraid Sir Ansbach will have to be next. He insists that he's nothing but a worn-down over-the-hill soldier. But in his day, he was the feared commander of the pure-blood knights, who cleaved open Mikala the Kime with his blood blade. He claims he hasn't the spirit to take up his sword again, but I doubt it'll be very long before he recalls, as I have, the cascading sheets of blood. I'm afraid he cannot be left to fester. I've come to a realization. There's ample evidence. Without kindly Mikala's influence, I'm quite mistrustful of others. I've come to a... There's ample... I'm quite mis... I've come to a realize... There's ample... I'm quite... come to a realization. There's I'm quiet. I've come to a there's I'm quiet. I've come to there's I'm quiet. Dispose of you. I find that I have a new apprehension for your ambivalence. Exactly where it might be.
So, you would cull an old man such as I. You're sorry indeed, Lady Lena. I would expect your advice. As you surmise, I do have my doubts. I will not expect Lena to die with them. Have you lost your wits? By my troth, you have no such debt to this old man. Though I gladly welcome your decision. Now I might even live to see the morrow. Lady Leda, I ask you keep kindly Mikola in your care.
to us all. Favor me with thy grace. I have met many who would threaten or distress thee, and quelled each and all. And I hereby swear to never cease. So please, grant me thy grace. Leave me with my solitary light. Queen Marika, I implore thee, bestow thy grace. Take not from me my solitary light. I would not. Am I not pure? Defile thee, I would never. I ask, why wouldst thou think to purloin from me? Deignest thou not to look upon me? All this time, I held in my heart only thee.
Thank you. Thank you. Mongrel intruder. That tarnished, it seemeth. Mother, wouldst thou truly lordship sanction in one so bereft of life? Yet, my purpose standeth unchanged. Those stripped of the grace of gold shall all meet death.
Thank you. not suffer. Our Lord, devoid of light. No, Mother. Forgive me. Thou be taken in the jaws